I've just been like guitar crazy with all this stuff, but I got through some of them. And I guess I'd do a little video about shaving down the bridge saddle. And take a look at a couple of these. I was impressed with the Ovation because they had a whole set of shims already built in there, and it allows you to excuse me, adjust the string action. So this one was pretty easy. I just popped it apart and pulled out the shim set that was already in there, and away we went. So that was that guy. That'll be a nice Christmas present for somebody. And we got another Yamaha. What's this one? Something or other. I didn't know it had this green till I cleaned off all the poop. But same thing, shaving the saddle and put some new strings on it. And I, you know, for someone just starting out, never had a guitar. Wow, that's not bad. Hold on. So to shave the bridge saddle to lower the action, if you want this to drop a certain amount, let's say for instance a 1/16 of an inch, you need to be able to take near 1/8 of an inch off of this. So this is how Dave calculates that. So if you wanted to take 1/32 of an inch off the space between the string and the fret at the 12th fret, you're going to take the double amount off the bottom. This won't pop out for me, but I'll just stop here. I'll show you what I do. With the strings on it, I make a fine mechanical pencil mark along there. You know, oh, there, lead went flying. The lead did fly. Okay, and stand by. Ouch. Oh, he got it out. Okay. So if you don't have anything, you get a piece of sandpaper and a flat surface, and away we go. Sometimes guys will put tape on their fingers and, you know, make it go that way. Like I said, and away we go. I'll show you how I do it. Hold on. In my carpenter's vise, I got jigged up two strips of brass. And if you look closely, the brass is, come on, focus camera, is set back slightly from the wood. So when I grip this, it's the wood that's gripping the actual saddle. Hold on, I'll show you what I do. Holy shit, I need 5 hands. So we can jig this up in such a way that we can actually measure how much we want to take off. And with the brass shims there, that's my stop. And then we use the sanding attachment there, and we basically just sand off the bottom of the saddle quick and dirty, real fast. And that's how Dave does it. So when the sander hits the brass, obviously I'm done. Okay, let's get this going. So I use the two E strings as dummies, and once again, if we have no tools, we're looking for that, you know, that beautiful 25 cent feel. Quarter should just slide under there. I think we got it. This is all we can do. The next step, if we really want to go farther with this, now we would have to shave the bridge itself to get more movement down of the strings.
Which isn't hard to do, it's just more time. So, 2, 3, 4 hours on the bench. A guitar like this gets the treatment once, and then there'll be no second time around. That's. $400 or $500 guitar, if you spend $100 on it, $120 on it at some point in time, I guess that's probably okay. I wouldn't spend any more. Bites the dust. The Yamaha bites the dust. And another one's done. And another one's done. The Yamaha bites the dust. Hey, you got screwed. Your Yamaha bit the dust. Oh yeah, and there's this thing. Well, it's glued back together, and I got some filler crap in here. I don't know. Do we think it'll hold? I don't know. Do we think it'll hold? Do we think it'll hold? I don't know. It might. That worked out great. Shave your saddle. And, yeah. I like it. But that's it. Like I said, if the guitar deviates more, and we don't know what's going to happen to it. It's going to play good for at least a week. Cheers, folks. I don't know. You think it'll hold? The Yamaha bites the dust. The Yamaha bites the dust. Logger, logger. The Yamaha bites the dust. The Yamaha bites the dust.